Burt Bacharach and Carol Bayer Sager.
So the evening is about our music, our songs, and sharing it with you. So you're going to be hearing some new songs, as well as older, more familiar songs like this one.
When you smile, I could tell.
we meet each other everywhere. My hands are shaking. Best lyric writer that we have writing in this country today is Carol Bayer Sager.
I just want to say, it's terrific to be back home here. We've been on tour a very long time this summer. Seemed to me a lot. We played some very big places. I was scared to go out on tour, but Burt told me here in California before we left that if we went out and promoted this album that I had nothing to be frightened about because he was going to be with me 100% of the time. This is Frank. Anyway, I didn't want Burt to leave, but there have been times in my life where I very much wanted someone to leave. I remember there was this one guy. Thank you. Reviewer that we say will seem slightly awkward. I write a lot with Melissa Manchester and Peter Allen. And he's in Australia, but I'll tell him to say hello. Morgan Hamlish and Mike McDonald of the Doobie Brothers, and most recently Christopher Cross of the Grammy Brothers. Anyway, I thought we could do some of those songs for you now. This first song was the second time I was ever nominated for an Academy Award. What it had in common with the first time is that both times I lost. Please, don't let this feeling end.
Thank you.
Well, we have spared no expense. We have toured the country by bus, messing this number up as we go. But tonight, we have this and one more chance to get it right. That's it. I put this in the medley. It wasn't a huge hit, but it was like a big She didn't do it. I didn't even mess it up. It's just the speech. Put this in the medley because it was a big performance song. If you watch a lot of television, or if you've been to Las Vegas, you may see Donnie and Marie do it. Or Sonny and Cher did it, and then Cher did it without Sonny. And Margaret and Anne Murray, and Peter did it with the Rockettes. But you've seen nothing until you've seen me do it. supposed to open. It's supposed to open kind of like more magically, but we'll get the next part. 5, 6, 7, 8. When trumpets were mellow, Dick the gallows had one bell. The wind, everything Otis knew again.
Thank you.
I read in the newspaper yesterday that I was frightened of flying. You can't believe everything you read. In this case, it happened to be true. We flew to Atlanta. We took this L-1011, which is a very safe plane. The pilot told me himself, Captain Bridges. You probably wonder how I know his name. I went into the cockpit and introduced myself, and he was based in Atlanta. He told me all about the L-1011. He told me it flies by computer, can land on its own. Matter of fact, he told me I was standing on the computer. I moved very quickly. And he also told me that I asked him if he wanted to come to our concert in Atlanta. And he said he'd love to because he was a really big Burt Bacharach fan. And anyway, he asked me how he went about getting tickets. And I told him I'd tell him when we landed. I thought we should fly on an incentive program. You get me to Atlanta, I'll get you to the concert. So he was there, he really was. Anyway, then we traveled by bus from there, and I felt a lot like Loretta Lynn in this bus. I did. Burt reminded me of Conway Twitty. We had this electric piano in the bus, and every time Burt sat down to write something, it came out like a country song. And we had a very strange bus driver, I must say. I said, in Austin, Texas, which was the last place we were before we came back to L.A., I was starting to get that anxiety about flying again. And I said, how long would it take us to get back from Austin if we took the bus? And he said to me that he could do it like in a day. And he was twitching and sweating profusely as he told me this. And I just had this very strong feeling that it was something other than his love of the road that was keeping him awake and driving so quickly. So nothing's really safe, see? You just have to take your chance.
Sky. Now that
know you're wet. Time has left us older. About 16 years now, I've been writing songs, and I write an awful lot about friends and home. I grew up in New York, and maybe my friends have always been real important to me because I'm an only child. I still write a lot of songs about home and friends, and I have my own home now here in California. I guess if I learned anything through the 16 years, I learned that it's not so much about where you live, but finding a place inside of yourself that you can be comfortable with.
Thank you.
'Cause I love you anyway, coming from the rain. School of exercise to work these microphones. This song about a girl in the music business. You may know someone like her. Some people come dangerously close to being a little like her. She's just a secretary in a small recording firm. But when it comes to music, there ain't nothing she can learn. 'Cause everything she lives and breathes is written on an album sleeve. She can tell you who is hot, who will make it, who will not. And she loves to hear the music, got every lyric down. She loves to hear them say she's got the greatest ears in town. She's there at every studio. There ain't a pop star she don't know. And sometimes they take her home. But she'll always wake up alone. They turn around and go. They leave her by the radio. She didn't love him anyway. Not like she loves the men who play. And she loves to hear the music. She got every lyric down. She loves to hear them say she's got the greatest ears in town. She's there at every studio. The first to come, the last to go. And sometimes they take her home. She'll always wake up alone. The years will not be kind to her. Her world is still young. The bands that played so tightly knit will all become unstrung. And she'll be just another face, out of time and out of place. Till the songs revive again, she'll come to life and tell you when.
Thank you.
You're really terrific. That's really true. And we were able to walk here, too. Please help me thank a very dear friend of mine, great pianist and musical conductor, Mr. Frank Peale. When Burt left before, I felt a little bit nervous. I'm feeling much more comfortable now. However, I'm going to leave and Burt's going to come back. He'll have a little breakfast doing his hits. Just a couple of them, you know. And if I have to leave, then I want to sing this song for you, Sandy. I'd rather leave while I'm alive. Well, I still believe the meaning of the word. I'll keep my dreams and just pretend that you and I are never gonna end.
Thank you.
Particular song is going to send her through school. Nikki's not too crazy about my singing either. She's got a lot of company there. I'd like to do a medley right now, some of the songs that Hal David and I have written together. In this medley, you'll be hearing some songs that are hopefully familiar to you. You'll be hearing some Academy Award losers, four of them. I heard Carol sing before that about being up for an Academy Award and losing twice. That's really some kind of feeling, sitting in the audience as a nominee, and the camera pans on you, and you're supposed to smile and throw the bastard when you lose, you know? All that stuff. I'm going to start out the medley with a surefire Academy Award loser. The year that this song was up for an Academy Award was like a 1-2 shot at the racetrack. Everybody said, Burt, there's no way you can lose. I don't know how many 1-2 shots you've seen it at the racetrack crash, but I've seen a bunch of them, including a couple of mine. We lost that year. As a matter of fact, the song we lost to is a song called Talk to the Animals. No, I ask you. orchestra that's assembled for this engagement here at the Roxy. Thank you, Carol. Some of the beautiful musicians. Great musicians. Thank you. Very nice. Carol told you a little about the bus. That was quite a tour. The last place that we played on that leg of the tour was in Austin, Texas. And a little bit different than this room. It was a nice, intimate place in Austin, Texas. It houses 22,000 people. University of Texas plays basketball in there. Made me feel like we should be playing basketball there. Brought me back to it. I always wanted to play basketball, you know. I was a very short kid growing up, so I never got to play basketball. But I did get to go to Africa with the Harlem Globetrotters when I was first starting in the music business. As the music director. A whole bunch of acts and then Harlem Globetrotters, you know. So I went along to North Africa because I thought that I could maybe get in the basketball game. Maybe for the last 2 minutes or something. I always used to say to Abe Saperstein, let me in for like one jump shot from the corner, Abe. You know? I never did. He always said, maybe you suit up tomorrow, Abe. You know? Maybe tomorrow in Tripoli. Never came about. It's a wild trip. I remember a chariot race with the late Barney Ross, who was a great, great fighter, and racing through the streets, both of us, totally drunk. He had a chariot, I had a chariot. He was colossal. Do you remember Barney Ross?
Yeah,
he was great. Okay. Quite a week this has been. I ran a horse, but some of you know I'm into horses. I ran a horse at Bay Meadows on Monday, a maiden. Maiden meaning a horse that's never won a race. And I don't know why they call them maidens, but when you break your maiden, you're no longer a maiden. I mean, you know. So this filly won at Bay Meadows on Monday, and she paid $87. We got back to reality and ran a horse on Thursday at Bay Meadows. A very slow horse, a very good-looking horse. I mean, he eats very well, he looks terrific. I can outrun this horse. He ran, and he got beaten by a total of 27 lengths, which is a little bit better than he did his last race before that, which is a total of 30 lengths he got beaten. This horse will eventually get banned from the tracks in California. It's a total embarrassment, choppy wearing nice silks. Wouldn't even ask him, like, will she make it again on this horse? I don't know what we're going to do with this horse, but I think he needs like a distance of ground, you know. Like about 200 miles south of here. Agua Caliente. Real cheap horses. That's where we went. They're fun, horses. Not overly, but... Okay, we'd like to do a song right now. If you ask me, do I have a favorite song that I've ever written, of all the songs I've been connected with, I can't say this is my favorite, but I have to put it in my first three or four. It's also an Academy Award loser. It's a song called Alfie. What's it all about, Alfie? Is it just for the moment we live? What's it all about? Saxophone family, piccolo, flute, anything he can put in his mouth, he'll play. Mr. John Phillips. John! Together with them, in this very fine orchestra, we'd like to play a piece that I recorded. My most recent album on A&M Records, I wrote specifically for the Houston Symphony, recorded with the Houston Symphony, right in Houston, Texas, in Jones Hall. The name of the piece, the name of the album is Woman, and the piece that we're going to do for you is called New York Lady. Thank you.
station without me. Sunshine without rainy days. We wanted it always. You and me. We reached for the sky. The limit was high. Never giving in. Certain we would win that prize. I should have seen it in your eyes. Look how all our dreams came true. See how I've got me, and baby, you've got you. Through it all, just one thing died. A little thing called love, feeling deep inside. We once were the best. Back when we were dumb, when did we become so smart? And learn to break each other's hearts. Look how all our dreams came true. See how I've got me. We once were the best. Look what we became. Isn't it a crying shame that we almost made it, but we wanted it all. We wanted it all.
The album that we did, and we wrote 9 of the 11 songs together. This song is on the album, and I wrote this with Peter Allen, and there's one other song that we wrote together, and we didn't write together, but that I wrote with Neil Diamond that's on the album, but we won't do that tonight because Burt can't play two songs in a row that he didn't write. It's literally impossible.
Let's do a song that we wrote together.
Doing fine. Hey, baby, I won't break. you say you want to. Yeah.
we came back, you know, because I forgot to introduce our background singers, Steve Carlisle and Tommy Thunderbolt. I see, I don't know if you're allowed to do anything. I see two ladies in the audience. One I know, and she's a good friend of mine. One I don't know, and I wish I knew, because I feel like I know her, because every movie that she's in, I feel like I just go crazy. You know what I mean? So one is my good friend, Mary Kay Place. And one I would like to be my good friend, and that's Goldie Hawn. Barbara Rush is here. That's great. You know Barbara Rush, too.
Hi, Barbara.
Anyway.
Neil
was here. How about that? Neil, Neil knows. How would he not know? We both wrote a show with you, just not at the same time. That's what it is, right? Yeah.
I should do it again.
Yeah, we would, Neil, because this is it. Our tour is over. So, anyway, this has been a really great week for us. One, we don't have to go out and do this anymore. We're home. We're here. No more buses. No more planes. And Burt scored a movie earlier this year called Arthur. Yesterday on KIQQ, which has now become the most important station in town, it went to number one. Had the song gone to number one on K Earth, that would have been the most important station. That's how it works. Talking about radio stations, I just saw a friend of ours that goes back a long time. You may not all know him in Los Angeles, though most of us know him because we all came from New York, and he's just about the father of pop radio, Marina Kay. Anyway, out of context, but getting back to the music, this is the song. Christopher couldn't be here tonight.
Thank you.
time. Well, I just saw an actress that's terrific, Beverly D'Angelo. I saw the man that co-produced the album with us, Brooks Arthur. Thanks, Brooks. Anyone else who might be at, well, I also, Neil Bogart is here, and Joyce Bogart, and they told us to make this album, so we thank you. And Jill Bogart, and just as Bar Mitzvah is what it all is. Just introduce each table now. Hello, and your name.
Question is, why do birds suddenly appear?
Long to be